Good day everyone. Welcome to Falafel Kitchen. Today's recipe will be making this spaghetti bread. Yes, spaghetti bread, everything like just like our normal spaghetti bread that we do in that spaghetti that we buy in our country. That is very soft. That is what we are making. Please, if you are new to my channel, welcome. And for my returning subscriber, thank you for joining me. This takes me to the point so I can make the secret for making this delicious and very soft dough. And I think this will be, these are the ingredients I'm going to be using. This is my flour. I have yeast. If you are going to be using yeast, lukewarm water, butter, vitamin C and sugar. Put on the tablespoons of sugar in small lukewarm water. And add the yeast in everything and leave it to activate. So, you need it to be activated. You need to mix in there. Then, you put it in one place so that it be activated. If you are new to my channel, please like, share, and subscribe. That is my first time to that I have a jar to add vitamin C and your sugar. You add all your dry ingredients to it. The vitamin C is just to absorb the yeast inside the plate so that it becomes soft and thick. And the vitamin C is just one tablespoon. Because I cannot find the powder drum where I need. I mix it up with 500 grams and I grind it like that and add it to my plate. Sometimes there is another 50 times. Sometimes I also have lemon or lime instead of yours. That's sugar and that's salt. It's just salt. Because we all contain vitamin C. You can't get vitamin C where you are. You can make it of orange or lemon instead of that. You do the same function. You perform the same duty. Yeah, you activated this. It's not like that when you say this is not activated. You have to throw it away and you use it for a good use. You need grill and you need the butter you put enough because I'll continue mixing this. If I see that I still have so many flour left. And I had my water and then add it. So she gradually mix gradually so that you don't have even noodle. The flour is very well. Then after this, I mix very well. Then I'm gonna add my butter. Before adding my butter, I need to already washed hands. Add the melted butter and mix very well. Mix very well. Now, still moving the flour dough. It's best to transfer to the work surface so that one can use the scale of the pan to move. Yes. Very well. I make a lot of bread at home because my children love it. They love it, especially when it's just coming out of the oven. They just continue to steam it. They feel like finishing it. Let the dough rest for the 2 minutes before continuing kneading because it gets the sugar to be resisting the kneading process. So, continue back, continue using Don't forget to subscribe to Colatas Kitchen. Please turn on the notification bell for more beautiful, delicious, and healthy recipes this time. Yes, healthy recipes. We have so many and lots of recipes to share in this time. And don't worry about our beauty. We are still coming up from that to share beautiful things about how to make hair, the lifestyle, the kind of lifestyle that I stood. Many things, talk about food, talk about lifestyle, talk about business, and yes, please share, like, subscribe, and comment. Yes, we do it ready. Start the meet for 20 minutes, total time of meeting is 20 minutes. Once you touch and it pans back like that, I mean, you do it already. I mean, it's done, you do it done. So, you do it, you still be transferred into the bowl. Yes. You add oil into the bowl so that it do not stick to the bowl and it do not form scar on top of the bowl. I mean, on top of the dough, please. Sorry, on top of the dough. So there will be no scar on it. And after that, you need to cover the dough and you need to rest in one place for 2 hours. For at least 2 hours. I mean, for 2 hours is okay. Sometimes my nose will be up to 2 hours, depending on the kind of weather you have, the kind of the weather of the country at the particular time you are making the bread. Yes. Bread pan that I'll be using. Please, the bread pan, you can use water, you can use oil, like this for some, or use water. Can use the oil, I'll add national paper so that the bread will not stick to the pan. So, that's what I'll do. National paper is already there now. Put bread pan in flour. That all this is just to prevent the bread from sticking to the pan so it can come out. So that to easily come out after the thing, coat it and tap out the excess flour after coating. This is it, the pan is ready. Tap it out after coating. So you can do that, you can break down next time. Yes, that's 2 hours. If it's the dough, you need your face here. Less than a day, not sticking, just because I've had it for 2 years. I sat in my work surface and poured in the chipboard. I cut into 2 parts because I have 2 pounds to bake the bread. Cut like this. You can also give suggestions of recipes if you want me to share in the description box. You know, you have a recipe in mind that you actually want me to share or you want me to tell you how to do it. I'm always ready to come at your service to share the recipe. But that is what we are, that is what I'm here for. Yes. Food is the size and shape of the pan. This is the spread dough. That's the first one. I put the pan on top so that I can be sure that my put the pan on top so that you can be sure that the dough is not too long and it's not too short. Be sure that we have the exercise of dough that will fit into the pan. So light it and pour it. Lock it in like that. then the last part like this, the pink, I should be the one under, not on top. Yes. Do it like this. Put it to the front. Yes, like that. And this is this. You repeat the same process. You have like I'm making soup set. Yeah, I'm waiting for to repeat the same process. I go eat out food, go eat out food, go eat out food, go eat out food. I think 3 to 4 times. It's okay. Eat out and food. Eat out and food. Repeat the same process for the second time. Yes. It looks stressful, but it's actually worth it. Because you know what we are eating, not be afraid of whatever is input then. And it makes everything. Then you know that yes, I'm not eating something that is baking, I know what I'm eating, I know the content of what I'm eating. Be rest assured. Okay. Can see easy. Can use the, I put the pan like that so that I can use to measure the size of my dough. And can see, and measure it like that and see that the size is fitting. Repeat the same process as the first one. The second one, I'm going to the pan. But can't wait for the bread. So cover the two now and put in one place. I put mine inside my oven. I put on the light because the light is warm for my oven. And this is, I left it to rest for 2 hours. So you leave it to rest for 2 hours or one until it doubles in size. That depends on the weather of where you buy it. If it's in the hot weather, do it nice easier. Yeah. And depending on how warm it is, the egg was. For my own, it took like about 2 hours to get to this stage. So I put the bread in the bread everything and bake it in. When you take the bread, the place will start in. You can guess. Our bread is ready. How long? It's ready. But I tell you the story behind this thing. I managed to keep my appetite down the day I ate this bread. Immediately my boy came back and saw this bread. It was just the only bread, the only bread. But this is the one I sliced. I have to dodge it though. Oh, hey, this one is finished with all of this bread tonight too. You cannot resist it. You can't take it. Look at it from the bottom to the top. Look at this medium brown. Let's look at the inside. I cut the bread after letting it to rest for about 5-10 minutes. Then I start sliding the size of that side of the bread. Very soft. Please, I want you to tell me what you like. What you would like to eat your own hot bread with. I'm saying you are the one that wants to eat this bread. For me, in those days, when I buy this kind of bread, and I fry fish, I don't want to judge your butter. This is what I use. I use. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Like and share. I'll see you next time. Bye bye.